Hi there, it's Screaming Steve, and it is Thursday, the 26th of June 2014. The world is mad. That is a cliche, I'll admit. Cliches is going to come up a wee bit later in this. I think most people are using cliches. I try to avoid them with the plague. But nonetheless, that cliche does sum up something that I've been wanting to do this video for like a few weeks now, right, about the world being mad. And then I joined Facebook, and then it just totally confirmed it to the point where, like, I can't do this video yet because there is just so much more to discover here about the craziness of the world. That I could put into this video. So now I'm doing this video, and I've been wanting to do this video for more than a few weeks in terms of like some of the stuff this video relates to. In terms of, like, let me just get to the point here, right? The world is mad, and the reason why I'm saying that is because most people have abandoned reason, or they've never had the ability to reason in the first place. And I think what I mean by reasoning is like reason, kind of like almost like logic, except like logic is kind of like it's in a very something that's logical is like in a very sort of closed situation, but reasoning is something that can be applied in a more in a completely unknown environment. As well as logic is a part of reasoning, but reasoning is something much more than logic. But the rules of logic do apply, you know. But most people don't. They don't have the ability to even question, to even think of the questions. Either because they've abandoned reason or because they never had the ability in the first place. And I suppose it's only kind of in the past few weeks that I've began to kind of realize this. Whereas when I was thinking about doing a video along these kind of lines over the past year or so, what I've been trying to do is trying to like get people to reason the reason why they should reason. Despite the fact that they don't reason, kind of thing. How could we set about getting people to reason? So some people are going to be saying, like, well, surely it's unreasonable for you to say that the world doesn't reason. Now, I say the world as in like most people. I don't know what the percentage is, like 98% of statistics are made up on the spot. I'm just saying it's a majority. I'd say it's significantly more than 50%. Maybe 98% would be an exaggeration. So I don't know, we'll say 75% of the world could be 80, could be 90, could be 60, could be 65, I don't know. I'd say it's probably more than 60. I'd say most people, they don't have the ability to reason. They do have the ability to use heuristics to kind of determine what's going on in the world. And I'd say that gets exploited by folk who probably do have the ability to reason, given the there is something like very sentient going on with a lot of the fucking negative. Let me just explain heuristics first, right? A good example, right, is when I first became a weather forecaster. I couldn't really predict the weather. If I wanted to predict the weather, I switched on teletext and it would say the weather's going to be like this. Haha, I'm a weather forecaster because I've got teletext. Now, what I mean is like the ability to predict. See these fucking trains? This is actually the third take of a video because the last two videos were kind of like disrupted by noisy trains coming through, going. It's not like they're like just next door, they're like half a mile away, but it's just a big sort of valley and it echoes out. But anyway, where was I? Right, heuristics. Weather prediction, my ability to predict the weather, came about through heuristics. I noticed that there was like a dark cloud. Whenever there was a dark cloud overhead, it was always raining. I didn't really spot that before. Some people are going to be like, ha, you didn't spot that before. I guess I did spot it, but I didn't pay much attention to it. But when I did start paying attention to these things, because living in the environment that I live in, you do start paying attention to nature a lot more than what you do when you're living in buildings and concrete and various other things. So rain and wind has become like very important things to be able to predict. So what I noticed was that over there, way over there, there's a dark cloud and the wind is coming in this direction. And I can kind of see that whenever there's a dark cloud over my head, it's always raining. So I could kind of predict on heuristics that that's what goes on, kind of thing. Now, reasoning that if there's a dark cloud over there and the dark cloud is headed in this direction, I can even get to the point of estimating how long it's going to take for that dark cloud to get here and say it's going to be raining in about 3 hours, or it's going to be raining in, well, usually a lot shorter periods of time than that, because the wind up there is usually much faster than I can see, kind of thing. You can only see the sky so far, and I suppose things are changeable then. But I can maybe predict the weather like an hour or two in advance. But part of that is heuristics and part of that is reasoning. But this is just like specific to me in these circumstances. But I don't think people have that. Most people have that kind of ability to reason. They would have to be told, like, this is how you predict the weather. Now, I have told you, like, that's how I predict the weather, by seeing a dark cloud moving in this direction. It'll take about an hour to get here, so I know it's going to be raining then. So now it'll be very obvious to you because I've just told you. But could you actually have worked that out for yourself? I hope you could. I hope you can, because the people I'm trying to attract to this channel aren't just folk that kind of like repeat parrot fashion, New World Order, government is tyranny, and people that can actually reason why government is tyranny, why the system is terrorism against the people. You know, I mean, it's not just like some catchphrase I'm using. I'm actually determining this must be the truth because reason says that, despite the fact if you're watching television that heuristics is telling you something completely different. And the people responsible for that heuristic programming, I would say that they can probably use reason as well, but most people can't. Most people, they walk into their job, let's just say a factory, right? It could be any job though. It could be a call center, it could be a nursing job, it could be any job at all, right? They don't sit like, let's, a factory, right, making cardboard boxes, right? Workers don't go in there and say, right, I've got cardboard and I'm expected to produce a box, so how do I go about producing a box from the cardboard? That's not what happens. That is not what happens. What happens is somebody says, cardboard boxes, this is how you put them together. No one applies any reasoning. They're shown how to do it, they're shown how to do it again, and heuristically, they work out how to put a box together. They don't apply any reasoning. Possible that they could apply reasoning after the fact that they've been told. Most people won't. That's my observation. And this is not just like a factory job. This is like most people doing jobs. They won't apply reasoning, and that's why most jobs are just about, and even like education, it's just learn this parrot fashion, because that's all most people are capable of, learning things parrot fashion. They're not actually capable of understanding the problem. They just know that if they've got 39 and they've got 45 and they've to put these two together, they know the steps that they need to go through, the steps that they've been told, the steps that they've been learned in order to do an addition. They don't understand, they don't comprehend the concept of what it is they're actually doing. They don't have an ability to reason. I'd say that in this day and age, I would say it's mostly because people have abandoned reason. And I think that could be the reason why a lot of people look in the kind of information we talk about and kind of think it's very negative. It's not negative at all, though. It's very positive. Because to actually see this stuff is a very important thing. Because it's kind of like a wilder beast in the Serengeti plain. And there's a lion there. And what would you say is more negative? Like the wilder beast to sit there happily munching grass. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy. And there's a lion just about to eat it. So another wilder beast walks up to the other wilder beast and he says, hey, Fred, there's a lion over there. And the wilder beast is like, oh, that's negative. I don't want to know anything about that. Munch, 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 munch. Happy wilder beast. Lion. You know, it's like, if you're going to just ignore negativity and call that like, it's negative people talking about negative things. It's not a very positive thing for you to do at all. Most people are just kind of like ignoring what's negative, despite the fact that it could save them from being eaten by a lion, just because they want to be happy. They want to be happy, 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 and it's only going to bring them sadness. And if they did something more positive by actually taking account of the negative, rather than walking around just being in a kind of like state of spiritual drunkenness, then they could actually reach a stage where they're content. I kind of wonder, I think I've not fully transcended the system, but I think I've probably did it more than most people ever have. And what I kind of think I think what a lot of people do, most people do, is like, they try to get into a state of complete contentment, and when they get to that state, they get bored, and then they go and do stuff to relieve the boredom, which breaks down their contentment. So it's one of these sort of cyclic things, but that's another thing entirely. But the regards to the happy, 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 and the lack of ability to reason. On a side note, I'm actually noticing people now, right, and I suppose there's a song going about just now, Happiness, or I think the song's called Happy, and the lyric is Happiness is the Truth. And I think that actually does sum up like a small proportion of the irrational people in the world. They actually believe that if they're sitting there with a bottle of vodka and it's making them happy, and then they run out of vodka, it's not the truth that they've ran out of vodka, because it's not making them happy to realise that there's no vodka left. So then you get this kind of like the law of attraction, it's called, and that's the idea that if you believe there's still vodka in an empty bottle, then vodka will be in the bottle. So I'm just kind of imagining there are folk out there who will be deluded into drinking an empty bottle, believing that they are drinking vodka out of an empty bottle and calling that the truth because it makes them happy. You never achieve proper happiness by being completely fucking insane. Most of the world have never had the ability to reason, or they've completely abandoned it. And that can be said as much in the truth movement, the freedom movement. But these these groups I kind of tend to be attracted to because there are a lot of people in there who are capable of reasoning. But within these movements, there's also a lot of people who are completely batshit crazy. Now, on the law of attraction, I think there's something to it, but not the way people are. People that talk in cliches haven't got a fucking scooby, and the people that are describing it as the law of attraction haven't really got any idea of the spiritual aspects that bring that about. I don't want to go into the spiritual aspects. I kind of try and avoid talking about spiritual aspects in any of my videos, because, well, it's quite a dangerous thing to get into. For me to actually communicate information to you about like the spiritual realm could give you information that will make you think of something that could, it'll make you realize, it could make you realize something that could actually affect you spiritually. So I would kind of avoid it because it would be a danger to people that are kind of watching, kind of thing. Maybe I should do a video about it and just put a big disclaimer at the start or something. But anyway, I don't think they actually get the whole sort of nature of like the spiritual world that causes law of attraction like phenomenon to occur. But most folk that are speaking about it are just speaking about like cliches. I heard it from this celebrity, even like celebrities within the Truth or the Freedom movement. I heard it from this celebrity, and they just repeat parrot fashion what that person said, and they don't actually have any clue because they don't have any ability to reason. Maybe the celebrity they're listening to has some ability to reason, but they don't. If the best they can do is like make a quote out of some book. When I come across this a lot, where I've kind of explained the reason and why I'm saying my thing, and in return, what I get is like, here's a book, go look at this web page, listen to what this guy says. No, why don't you tell me in your own words what it is you're saying rather than sending me to some website or telling me about some book? Is it the fact that if you're in the middle of a conversation and you need to actually defer your own intelligence, your own ability to reason to a book, it's dubious whether you've got any reason in there at all. Always try and seek out intelligent conversation. An intelligent conversation does not involve somebody in a book said something. That's just repeating parrot fashion. That is the heuristic mind. Everybody's got a heuristic mind, there's only some of us that have got the ability to reason. And people hate reason because there are people who use reason for very terrible things, like exploiting folk who are simply heuristically programmed. If you've abandoned reason, if you've abandoned reason, come back to it. Try and apply your reasoning to the things that you're being told. If they tell you 100 times that, now let's just get a very controversial example here, and I dare say there's people, David Cameron is a paedophile, right? So if they tell you 100 times that David Cameron is a paedophile, does it actually make it so? Does it actually make it so just because 100 people have told you that and nobody else hasn't? Or it could be the fact that the television has like told you 100 times that David Cameron is definitely not a paedophile. It doesn't make it so just because you're told something 100 times. I do something a bit kind of, I don't know, geeky or whatever it is, right? And I kind of look at the word, like, there's a separation between knowledge I've acquired from observation and knowledge I've acquired from things people have told me. If somebody tells me something that I find is quite interesting, I'll go and I'll make my own observations. But I don't just believe them because they said it was true. Because, like I said, most of the world are incapable of actually knowing anything. If somebody tells them something 100 times, doesn't matter whether it's like David Icke or Alex Jones, or whether it's like some celebrity in the mainstream media, if they're told 100 times something's true, they'll believe it because they've been told it so many times by perhaps so many different people. Therefore, it must be true. But they don't actually realize that, wait a minute, I don't actually observe this. I'm just being told this. They don't make any distinction there at all. What I'm saying to you is like, most people out there are mad because they don't have any ability to reason. And I think a lot of them are, it's more that they've abandoned reason rather than never had the ability in the first place. There's some people that watch me because there's kind of legal things that I do. Well, the legal things that I'm involved in. And there's an interesting thing regarding the reason with regards to courts. And a lot of the kind of like rules, laws, statutes, judgments rely on this idea of reasonableness. And when they've been asked what is the definition of reasonable, they've said the answer they've given is that it's whatever a reasonable person thinks is reasonable. You know? And if you're reasonable, you'll actually see the joke in that, because it's kind of like, to try and explain it to folk that don't get it, it's kind of like using the word reasonable to explain what reasonable is. This is what we're actually looking at our institutions that we are all bound to obey by the threat of violence. They're all fucking mad as well. Most of the world is crazy, and I think the people who are in charge of these kind of like, well, the courts just don't arrive by like the people saying, oh, let's have a judge. That's heuristics bollocks you hear on TV. The courts actually arrive because somebody a long time ago gathered a big army of people, conquered a place, and then says, everybody's got to obey my laws, and I'm going to put these courts there to make sure you obey me and the people who support me. And that's how the courts arrive. This is what they call lawful and moral, and it's bullshit. The people that are in charge of these institutions are evil fucks. And they do have the ability to reason. I'll admit that. I'll admit that the reason is not morality. And I've yet to find a rational basis for morality. I wonder if it exists. But right now, I'm sort of convinced that morality comes from a different place than reason. It may also come from the same place that this, I want to be happy all the time and ignore lions that are going to eat me, comes from. But if you aren't using reasoning, if everything that you've ever learned is based on learning things parrot fashion and never understanding what it is you're learning, then you're doing yourself a great injustice because you're capable of so much more. Being a human being is a very special thing. That sounds like one of these kind trains. Being a human being is a very special thing, and that sounds a bit like one of these cliches. but have a specific reason for saying what I'm saying. There is no other creature like a human being. I keep chickens, and there are creatures which rely on chickens. But the mice, for one thing, rely on the chickens being fed corn. But even the when chickens do a crap, if they were even just living as like feral chickens as opposed to free range, and I wasn't feeding them any grains, there's other creatures that would live off their poop. There's creatures that would live off their feathers, even just to build a house. Because a chicken is a very special creature in the whole general scheme of things. And the mice that kind of rely on the chickens, they're a very special creature in the whole scale of things. But a chicken's more special, and a human's more special than a chicken. A human's more special than a dog, because lots of life forms rely on humans. In fact, there are life forms which rely on you that you aren't even aware of the existence of. You are a leader amongst creatures, both animal and plant, whether you like it or not. Maybe the whole debate between good and evil comes in, depending on how you're going to treat the creatures that you are aware of. And when you're looking up to these institutions that are built by violence and maintained by violence, thinking they're moral, you're not applying any reasoning whatsoever. I'll leave you with this. It was something somebody said to me recently. It may have been in a forum or it might have been in Facebook, but they said governments aren't bad, and then went on to explain like the good things that governments do. And of all those things, there's good things that governments do. Equally, I believe humans could do those things without government. I think government actually hinders humans' ability to do it in order to monopolize it under their own banner. But that point aside, he said that governments are not bad. Governments are the most evil organizations on planet Earth. There is no entity which can create so much death and so much suffering, so much enslavement and so much hindrance upon humanity like a government. Governments are built on violence, they're maintained by violence. They are constantly threatening aggression against all people in the territories which they claim they have some moral right to control. I would hear an argument saying that governments are a necessary evil, but to say they're not even bad, that's a complete lack of reasoning. Freeman Stephen out.